Welcome to the press conference after the executive committee of the UEFA and prior to two most important matches for UEFA this year, Women's Champions League finals today and Men's Champions League finals in Saturday. Just to summarize about our decisions and then we can go to the questions. So we decided about the hosts for the UEFA Champions League finals, UEFA Europa League finals, UEFA Women's Champions League finals, which will for the first time not be in the same place as UEFA Men's Champions League finals and UEFA Super Cup. UEFA Champions League finals will be at Atatürk Olympic Stadium, Istanbul. UEFA Europa League final will be at Arena Gdansk, Poland. UEFA Women's Champions League Austria Arena, Vienna. And UEFA Super Cup Estadio do Dragão, Porto. Then the UEFA Executive Committee approved today the new edition of club licensing and financial fair play regulations for further strengthen the existing rules and to adapt to the ever-evolving environment of European football. At the end, I think you got it, the UEFA Euro 2020 final tournament match schedule was approved. The match pairings and the kickoff times will be added after the final draw in December 2019. And finally, the UEFA Executive Committee appointed George Kumas, president of the Cypriot FA, to replace the late Kostakis Kotsokoulis on the FIFA Council until the Congress of UEFA on 7th of February 2019. Those are the main decisions.
Thank you, President. We open the floor for questions. Derek?
I saw your comments yesterday to the European Union. You were talking about the only selling the soul of football. And also, a lot of people think that soul of football is already in the soul of the world. What is
that
they're trying to say
when
a lot of it's already
been sort of it's a big difference between clubs and between governing bodies. And governing body has to develop, has to distribute the revenues generated properly. We are not paying out the profits. We are sharing the profits with our national association. It's a bit of a different situation than you want to do.
Next question.
Yeah, in your speech yesterday to the European Union, you mentioned about how UEFA wants to deal with the imbalances in the game and so on. One of the things that stopped that happening in the past is the European Union's own regulations. Did you yesterday have any opportunity to talk about is there some change you want to see for them to allow you to look at things like salary caps and that kind of thing?
We presented the problems that we have and where we need their support. And we started the discussion, but I can't offer you any solutions for now. I just had the first meeting, I had a speech there and a kind of a round table with all the ministers of sports of the European Union and then let's see how it develops. In any case, we need some involvement.
Just a follow-up. So is that your goal to get them to start to change some of the legislation that governs football?
There are some things that we said should be done or at least discussed. For example, the free movement of the working force, is it the time to say that not just football players but athletes are an exemption? They should think about it because it harms the competitive balance. If players or young children from small clubs or small countries leave small clubs or small countries very soon, because stuff like that. But again, it was just a discussion. I don't want to say what we see yesterday.
Here in the middle.
A quick question on tickets for the Champions League. It's such a momentous game, and fans from both clubs want to come and see the game. Are you aware of the prices that some of the fans are having to pay? And it's a way for maybe looking into that bigger movie so tickets don't get flooded onto that market, because there were similar sorts of problems in the music industry, and they're dealing with that. I'm wondering, is there ever looking at possibly the next Championship round? Deal with that, so fans
aren't
being boxed out.
Yeah, it's a big problem that we know about everywhere and have been before. We cancel the tickets that are on the record. But the thing is that I'm not sure if it's possible to completely prevent that being possible. Maybe Martin, you have something to add. Thank you, President. I think we have a good and fair distribution system to the fans. 70,000 tickets goes each to the Liverpool and 7,000 tickets to Real Madrid. And a few thousand tickets goes to the Czech Republic. And the remaining tickets are for the stakeholders of the family. So we are, on that side, we are already distributed more than 70% of the tickets to football fans, and we are looking carefully on the black market system. We have a system in place where several lawyers and authorities are looking at that. Of course, there are still people selling their tickets. We will be looking to prevent that, but as President said, it's not 100%
It seems Real Madrid returned about 2,000 tickets. Can any of them look more fans who can't get tickets?
Who's asking that? Yeah. I didn't hear you.
Real Madrid returned tickets, it seems about 2,000. Will they be given to Liverpool fans who can't get tickets?
No, first it's not 2,000, it's 1,000. That's one fact. And the other is, of course, for security reasons, prevent us to carry to the Liverpool.
In the middle?
Yes. This is great. Okay. Just a question about the financial fair play. What are the sentences that have been decided or taken against the club that doesn't respect the financial fair play, like for example Paris?
I can't speak about concrete cases, especially the cases that are dealt by our independent bodies. So you will have to wait and see.
But for global thinking, what kind of sentences will be taken? Not about Paris, but about any clubs. What are sentences that will be taken?
These are different. There are fines, the deduction of points, excluded from competitions, many possible things in that. I'm not talking about PSG, I'm not talking about Milan, I'm not talking about Real or Liverpool.
Hello, Conta from Agence France-Presse. I'm wondering if you are happy with this season of the Champions League, the drama in this edition, and if you're not worried that the next season, the next format will be less dramatic and avoid dramatic in Champions League. Thank
you. I doubt it will be less dramatic, because the drama in principle starts at the end. So it could be the same, it will be interesting. Not, I can't say it will be more interesting, but it will be at least as interesting as now.
Next one here.
Hi, Richard Martin from Reuters. I wanted to know if political situations come into consideration when you're choosing Champions League final. Obviously Turkey is it's a country with a difficult political situation at the moment with lots of oppression, and do these things have any influence?
I don't know what you mean by political situation, but we are not a political organization, so we can't judge political situations in any country. We just have our rules, and by those rules, we decide at the end. So politics should enter the decision-making process and governing policies.